Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Tuesday, SpaceX successfully launched their 128th Falcon Mission of the Year with the launch of Kuiper KF-03. The booster which launched this mission, B1091, then landed successfully for the second time on the drone ship in shortfall of gravitas. A couple of days later on Thursday, SpaceX successfully launched their 129th Falcon Mission of the Year with the launch of T1 TLC.
One, ignition, and liftoff of Falcon 9. Go SpaceX, go SDA.
The booster which launched this mission, B1093, then landed successfully for the seventh time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You. Then, later the same day, SpaceX successfully launched their 130th Falcon Mission of the Year with the launch of Starlink 1052.
One, engines full power, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1095, then landed successfully for the third time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Land and land deploy.
Then, a few hours ago, SpaceX successfully launched their 131st Falcon Mission of the Year with the launch of Starlink 1017.
One, engines full power, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1067, then landed successfully for the 31st time, becoming the first booster to do so on the drone ship a shortfall of gravitas.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
Then, a couple of hours after that, SpaceX successfully launched their 132nd Falcon Mission of the Year with the launch of Starlink 1119.
1, ignition. Engines full power and liftoff. From 1010 to 10,000, go Starlink, go Falcon, go SpaceX.
The booster which launched this mission, B1088, then landed successfully for the 11th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Landing leg deploy.
This coming week, we can hopefully expect to see a few Falcon missions launch. The first of these, the Starlink 115 mission, is currently scheduled for Wednesday 22nd at 3 p.m. UTC or 11 a.m. EDT. A day later and we should see a customer mission launch. The SpainSat NG2 mission is currently scheduled for Thursday 23rd at 2:30 a.m. UTC or Wednesday 22nd at 10:30 p.m. EDT. A couple of days after that and we should see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 1112 mission is currently scheduled for Saturday 25th at 3 p.m. UTC or 11 a.m. EDT. Less than an hour after that and we should see yet another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 1021 mission is currently scheduled for Saturday 25th at 3:27 p.m. UTC or 11:27 a.m. EDT. Related to the first Starlink landing, SpaceX posted some information about a huge milestone. They said Falcon 9 completes its 500th landing after lifting off from Pad 40 in Florida. Earlier this week, SpaceX successfully launched their 11th flight test of Starship and Super Heavy with the launch of Starship Flight 11.
One. We have liftoff. Go Super Heavy. Go Starship. Thanks for all the historic flights, Pad 1.
The Booster 15 vehicle used on this mission flying for the second time after being caught underwent successful hot staging separation.
Spec burn startup.
Super Heavy then simulated a return to launch site with some more strenuous testing, hovering before falling to its demise in the Gulf.
See a bit of a hard thing.
Booster landing burn startup.
Like with last time, Starship successfully deployed its dummy Starlink satellites during its coast phase.
And I mean, we're using Starlink to bring all of this together.
Starship also performed yet another in-space engine relight of a single Raptor engine.
Right, there was that Raptor relight. Looks like engine 3, full duration.
Starship re-entered the atmosphere in what looks to be the best shape we have seen any Starship before after re-entry.
Round orbital velocity, which is roughly 8 kilometers per second or 5 miles per second.
Then SpaceX did an interesting maneuver as Starship aimed for splashdown in the Indian Ocean. They said Starship is executing a banking maneuver that mimics the final approach it would take while returning to Starbase for a catch on a future mission. Finally, Starship 38, the last version 2 Starship, performed an amazing soft splashdown in the Indian Ocean pretty much on target.
3 down to 2.
Starship has landed.
Here's a much better look at the Starship and the landing burn it performed after doing its flip maneuver. Elon Musk gave some information on the performance of the heat shield during this flight test. He said the new heat shield performed much better. That was the main objective. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.